Hi, good morning. I'm Chris. I'm here. Hey, Monica, are you there?
Yep.
Hey, Monica.
Hello.
I've got MJ's picture up instead of Monica's picture, which, well, that sucks. I shouldn't do that. Wait, I can change that. I have that technology. I'm going to delete that. Goodbye, MJ. I'm going to add in Monica. I'm going to add in Nelson, too, because he's going to be here soon. If Skype will ever work. Oh, there's Monica. Okay, cool. So, Monica, where did you leave off in your playing of the game? Where were you when you quit?
I stopped at Fayborn 6.
Fayborn 6?
Yep.
All right. I think I'm going to continue where you left off.
Okay. The next one's Fall of Moonlight Vale. All
right. Fayborn 7. Oh, I remember this. What's a nice short one? All right. So let's see. Is anyone here? Oh my goodness! Legendary Bacon Gaming is here. That's kind of cool. They're not saying anything, but you know, it's cool they're here. I feel their love right here. So anyway, we're still trying to get Nelson on Skype, which is still not working. I don't know whether to like blame. I don't know, like I could either blame Skype or I could blame Microsoft. I don't know who to blame. We could also play a multiplayer game, Monica. Which would be more fun.
I can play multiplayer.
I'm curious. Is there anybody in the lobby? There's nobody in the lobby today. Hop in, let's play some multiplayer. This'll be fun.
Alright, just a sec.
All right, let me go tell the kids. MJ.
Hey, kids.
At Nelson. Come play multiplayer. At Ben. Not Ben. At Ben. Let's play multiplayer. All right. I should probably play the Steam version if I want to play multiplayer though, right? Steam build. Yeah, we'll play the Steam build. Alright. I'm going to turn that off and open up my fancy Steam version of the game. Come to me, Steam version of the game. There we go. No, wait. But I have to turn it back on here, don't I? I have to tell it what it is. There we go. Cool. Alright, there's the Steam version of the game. Oh wow, I'm a big green bear. Hey, I won a VP Skirmish game. I don't know why it tells me
Hey, there are other players in the lobby.
Are there? We should
I think you were using the dev build.
I was using a dev build. Oh wow, there's like real humans. We should like see if we can make them play with it. It's so cool that we have people in the lobby now. Like, I don't know where they're coming from or, you know, where they found out about us, but I'm excited about it.
Jay Papas is from PAX East.
Jay Papas?
I think I've seen him and Spunky Shell every day in the lobby.
Well, let's invite Spunky Shell to a game. I'll play with him. I'm cool. I'm gonna host a game. I'll host Sea of Tusks. That's a nice big game. I really need
just
to unlock.
Casual or round?
I want to unlock more stuff. Actually, why don't you? You've got more crap unlocked, don't you?
Not sure.
Have you got Sorinthia unlocked? Because I want to play Sorinthia.
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, why don't you invite me and invite everyone else to a game in Sorinthia?
Is this casual? Or
yeah.
Round? Okay.
So what the reason I wanted you to come today, Monica, I wanted to talk about some marketing stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I was talking to a good friend who works over at Tiny Build. Shout out to Tiny Build. Who never come to our... They're never here. They don't know that I'm shouting out to them. But I'm still shouting out to them because they're nice people. They're the guys who did Punch Club. And they didn't make it. They published it. They also published Speedrunners. Anyway, they're good friends of mine. I like how I name drop, you know. Hey, they're good friends of mine, you know. But they are actually good friends of mine. That's not, like, bullshit. Hey, I got challenged to a game in Sorinthia. Okay. And they brought up some good points, because I was saying, hey, we should, you know, we're planning on shipping the game the last week of May. He said, actually, there's, he didn't remember what, but there's apparently some rather big titles coming out in May, like that last week of May, and we might not want to compete with them. So it might be better to do in the next week, because they're going to be on the top of the list. So what we might want to do is do a check and see who's coming out at the time we're thinking of coming out, and making sure that we're not coming out on top of somebody who's going to kick our ass. That was thing one. And then thing two was... Oh, by the way, set up for quick start, would you? Set up...
Okay.
Actually, can you just unlock the game options and I'll play with it?
What?
There's a button that says lock game options.
Ah, okay.
Unclick that. Okay, good. Then I can click shit.
Yep.
Because I want quick battle scenes. And I want to do that. All right. And I want to be... What color do I want to be? I
hey, there's a lock missing.
Where?
In the chat. Option underscore starting underscore gold underscore more.
Okay. Let's see. I want to be yellow, damn it. And I want to start in... Oh, you're doing the random start position? Let's choose start position. That's more fun.
Okay.
No, so I was saying, okay, so A, what we need to do is we need to go look and make sure we're coming out in a week that doesn't have, like, something that all of Steam has been waiting a year for coming out. And then he had a really interesting point that we really need to take to heart. Apparently, they don't update Steam on weekends, right? And so if you get put in the, like, new and interesting category on a Friday, you're there all weekend. And so he was saying they always launch their titles about 11 o'clock a.m. Seattle time on Friday. And apparently if you launch at 11 o'clock a.m. Seattle time on a Friday, that means that you'll be, if you do well, if you get high in the rankings, you'll sit high in the rankings for the whole weekend. Mm-hmm. Why did everyone just get made unready?
And Betamax joined.
Hmm.
Merlini's joining.
Yay.
Is
go on,
he
MJ.
Watching too?
Click your button. Ready, ready, ready. Alright, off we go. I love this map. Sorinthia is one of my favorite maps. I don't know why. Oh, I didn't get the starting position I wanted. I feel cheated. But I did get to be yellow.
We're neighbors.
Are we neighbors? Alright. I wonder, can we, who, so, alright, so, let's see if I can get Nelson in the chat. Did Ben play? Is Ben with us?
Nope.
Who's playing with us? Who's in?
Merlini from PAX East.
Oh, cool. Hi, Merlini. I don't know if Merlini's watching. I don't know if Merlini knows that they're online right now. Like, do they know that we're... I don't know. I feel bad, but all right. But MJ, we get MJ. He's one of us.
Hmm.
Let's see if he answers his phone. Otherwise, it'll just be us. All right. Yeah, I'm done. So what else can we do for our big launch? So I'm assuming it's still going to be right around the end of May, whether it's that week or the week after, I'm not really bothered, but it'll be right about then. We're going to do the big tournament, right? What do we need to do to hype up the tournament?
Are you still going to do that continuous live stream?
Hell yeah! I'm going to do it.
I think that could be the start of like hyping up this stuff.
I'm thinking to do it next week.
Okay.
I'm going to set aside 3 days for it, because it can't possibly take longer than 3 days, right? I mean, if it does, then...
Up to you.
I think I've failed, right? If it takes longer than 3 days, I don't know if I'm capable of staying up that long.
I think Valentina Panda is watching.
Who? Oh, cool.
Nina from US, the Filipina. Hi.
Yeah, she was totally cool. Yeah, I met her and some dude. I don't know if it was her boyfriend or a dude, but the two of them came by. They were really nice. Her and a dude. A dude.
Nope.
Hey.
Hello.
Somebody's here. Hey, MJ.
Hello.
Are you you're playing your Scribble dude, right?
Yeah.
All right, cool. Oh wait, you're my neighbor. You're my other neighbor. Has anyone allied yet? Nope, nobody's allied yet. I shouldn't have said anything. Now there's going to be like a furious series of alliances that don't involve me. Wait. I'm going to ally with the dude from PAX. That'll be fun. Let's see if they'll take my alliance. I shouldn't have told you guys that. Woohoo! We're allied. I have a friend. They don't know what a shitty ally I am, so they allied with me. They don't know the dirty secret that I'm a terrible, terrible ally. Alright, let's see. That's gonna go badly, isn't it? Well, actually, it's not gonna go so bad. I'm gonna go with it. I'm gonna make that happen. Alright. Alright, so how do we get any... Because I have this fear that I'm going to be streaming for 3 days, basically for you, Monica. You'll be the only person watching for 3 days. So how do we get anyone to watch me stream for 3 days?
What?
I mean, that's the joke of modern media, right? Everything is like an online event, but you have to, you know, and the... Oh, shit, that doesn't look good for me. the online event is supposed to hype the thing, but then you have to hype the online event to get people to show up at the thing. It's kind of madness, really.
Forgot to do things.
All right, let's see what happens here. Die. That didn't go as well as I hoped it would.
I was going to use bumper crop, and I forgot to use it.
Alright, so my little plan to go take that tower there was poorly made. I have to try that again. That was I'm really ashamed of that kind of piss poor attempt. I'm actually losing to the AI. I have both you and I have Monica and MJ allied against me on either side of me, and I'm managing to lose to the AI. That is, I'm feeling very shit about myself right now. I'm just not I'm not much of a man, really. Alright, but I'm gonna stand up for myself. I'm gonna make it happen. I'm gonna make it work. I still have high hopes. I'm gonna build a little island full of towers. So is it still like brutal hot down in the Philippines? Like my Facebook channel is full of nothing but Filipinos bitching about politics and heat.
Yeah, it's really hot.
And your politicians really suck. You have both of those things going for you.
Yeah.
Yes.
Really scared.
But I can't complain because as of, I don't know if you guys noticed this, as of like a couple hours ago, Ted Cruz quit, which means the Republican nominee for president will definitely be Donald Trump. That actually happened this morning.
I don't know who the other person is. I don't know what that means.
Well, there's two political parties in America that matter, right?
Democratic and
Republican. There's the Democrats and the Republicans. And the Republicans are the sort of right-wing conservative types, and the Democrats are the more sort of left-wing progressive types. In theory, they don't actually always play out that way. But they've basically sort of taken little groups for themselves, right? Cosplay as a wizard with a fake beard. I have a real beard. I don't need a fake beard. I got, what is this? Like chop liver? I got the beard. Maybe I get a bigger beard. A better beard. Like a ZZ Top beard. But no, so anyway, you got the Republicans, you got the Democrats. And right now we're in the primaries, which means the Republicans and the Democrats get to choose who's going to be their dude. Or in the Democrats' case, their chick. Maybe their chick. Probably their chick. So, anyway, the only person that was really standing in the way of Donald Trump being the Republican nominee was Ted Cruz, and he just quit because he realized he couldn't win. So now it's going to be the American election is going to be Donald Trump versus somebody, and that somebody is more than likely going to be Hillary Clinton. So that's what we're going to look like. So, I know who Duarte is, right? He's that guy that, like, kills the criminals down in Mindanao, right?
Duterte, yeah.
How do I pronounce that?
Duterte.
Dude, I can't say it nearly as, like... You sound all, like, ethnic and shit when you say that. I can't... Do it again. That was cool, actually.
Duterte.
There's, like, a rolling of an R in there somewhere that I can't do. Alright, so there's that guy. And he's basically, like, famous for being the guy that kills all the bad people in Mindanao, right? That's, like, his thing?
Yeah.
So, who's the other people? What's my other choice? What?
My head hurts just by talking about them.
MJ could answer the question. MJ's a fine, upstanding citizen.
There's a bunch more... running for president, there's a candidate that denounced her Filipino citizenship for an American citizenship, then went back to becoming a Filipino citizen. Because her father died. She was running for president to the last election. There's another candidate who's supposedly involved in a lot of spiking up the prices for projects in Makati. And there's another candidate who's a cancer survivor, as she says. So, and the last one is the
current secretary for local government.
See, I like how you described each one of those candidates by something that has absolutely nothing to do with the policies they support. There's like, well, you can have the person with a cancer, or the guy who was a corrupt builder, or the person who used to be American, but like none of that explained in any level like what they would do as a politician. There was no, like,
I think nowadays you try to not talk about what their platforms are, because most of the time it would end up in arguments.
Yeah, but I mean, isn't that the point? Isn't like the whole point to having a politician to have them do things? I mean, isn't that what you want them to do? Things, right?
Yeah, but the issue with Philippine politics is they almost always say what you want to hear, but they never do what they say. It's like
that. But that's not Philippine politics. That's like the world politics. That's, you can say that for any country.
It's more about getting into position more instead of really helping people. That's why the guy who is from Mindanao is kind of popular, because people want change, but I don't know why, because doesn't take a new president for change to happen if you want to change. I don't know.
I don't know. It seems a little bit to me like Duterte is like the Trump of the Philippines. Like, he fills the same role of like, I'm just really pissed off about politics and I don't really care who this guy is, but he's not part of the normal system and I'm just fed up with the normal system, so I'm voting for him.
Yeah,
I mean, I've tried really hard to understand the whole Trump phenomenon, because I mean, that guy is just a complete piece of shit as a human being. I'm sorry if anyone's a Trump supporter, but that guy is just a terrible, terrible excuse for a human being. But he's not part of the system, and people are like, I'm so sick of the system, I'll elect a complete asshole to be president, because I'm that angry. You know, it's almost like a protest vote. I don't know. I'm actually very interested what next election cycle's election looks like, because like, then there's going to be people. I wonder if we learned anything from this. Like, has anything changed? Is anything going to be different? I don't know. It's an interesting question.
I think Chris is distracting us so that we won't fight him.
Nelson is giving me shit about my inability to pronounce Duterte. Is that right? Did I say it right that time?
Again, I didn't hear it.
Duterte. Am I close? God damn it. This is why I never study Filipino, because you guys laugh at me when I get it wrong. I don't laugh at you and your shitty Japanese.
You did laugh.
Well, okay, yeah, I do. But you're...
Hey,
the thing
there's
is,
another missing law. No.
What's missing?
This part.
Has dropped out of the game.
Who dropped out?
Who dropped out?
Not sure.
But we're still all here, right?
Oh my god, did my ally drop out of the game? Am I allied with the fucking AI now?
I see.
Oh no!
Hey, Alara Shade is also watching. Hello.
Wait, who's here?
Alara Shade.
Oh, Alara Shade. Yeah, okay. I believe I met that person. It's highly possible I met that person. All right, I'm like so goldbound because I built all of these. I got scared and I was like, I'll build fortresses all around my island, which was really a bad call. Because
actually,
now,
when you were saying that out. Wondering about it.
Like, I thought, you know, it might help me to build a bunch of fortresses, but in the end, it just means that I'm not getting very much money, and I'm not pleased with the way things are turning out for me right now. I'm sad. Sad, I tell you. But that's alright. I'm gonna suffer through. I'm still gonna win this. I'm hidden on my little island, and life is gonna be good. But I gotta get out and see the world a little bit if I'm gonna make any money.
Raise the buildings.
Meridor is kind of like, it's like the Australia of the risk board. Oh, hello! And I agree, Khaleesi for president. I would totally vote for Khaleesi. Especially if she'd like nurse the dragons there on the, because that was a good scene. That was, I was happy with that scene. But I shouldn't say that. I should keep that to myself. But it was there. It happened. So like, by the way, no Game of Thrones spoilers. I am not watching this season until it's over. That's my deal. I'm gonna wait until the whole season's over and then I'm gonna watch it. And so nobody can tell me anything or say anything about anything.
Okay.
That's the rule. Anyone breaking that is no longer my friend. That's like how you stop being my friend, is you say anything at all about this season of Game of Thrones. That's how you, that would be the end of our friendship, whatever friendship we might have. I was not going to watch the series at all. Actually, I promised myself I was not going to watch it all, because I read the books up to where the books stopped. And then I was like, alright, I'll wait until they're done with the whole series, and then I'll watch the whole series in one big Netflix binge. And then I broke one day, and I started watching them, and I watched all the way until where they left off last season. And I was like, oh my god, that was some of the best TV I've ever watched. And now I want to see more of it. And now they're making more of it, but, like, I don't want to be caught in that, like, every week getting all, like, I like binge watching my TV. You guys watch Game of Thrones, right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Have you been watching the recent series? Don't say anything about it.
Haven't yet. I'm still catching up on season 5.
I haven't watched this week's episode.
Yeah, alright, I'll do that. I'll play. Have some armor. Can you wear armor? Yeah, you can wear armor. Yay, armor! I've angered the MJ this time. Now wait, if I'm allied with the... Alright, MerliniX is still here. Alright, cool. Did Nelson drop out then? Somebody dropped out. A Param dropped out. But I don't know who. Must be Nelson. He was the only other person in the game.
Yeah.
And he hasn't replied again.
Alright, well, somebody should go kick his butt while he's out. Go kill Purple, MerliniX. That's what you
Merlini.
Should do.
MerliniX?
Is that how do you know to say it that way? Like, how do you know better than me how to pronounce something you've never heard pronounced? What makes you better?
I went to their channel.
Oh, look at you go. Alright. Was it cool? Was it awesome? Say yes.
Yes.
Alright. See, that was the only appropriate answer. You couldn't be like, yeah, I went there. It was totally terrible. It was awful.
I think if I say more, Merlini might be a bit weirded out that I know things.
I'm always weirded out that you know things. I know that's wrong. I know at this point, I should just accept the fact that you know things, right? You've been around long enough, you've known enough things that I should be like, yeah, Monica, that chick knows shit. Like, I should be there by now. But, like, every time you know something, I'm still just a little bit surprised about it. And I know that's rude, but... I don't know why I'm not right. I think I'm just a shitty boss, really.
I remember when we changed all our names to Game of Thrones names in HipChat.
Did we do that? I never played along with that.
No, not you. Some of us.
So by everyone, you mean the cool kids?
Yep.
The Flips? Is that... Do we get to call the Filipinos the Flips? Is that a thing?
I'm not sure.
Is that a Filipino thing, or is that... See, and this is something I've always tried to explain to Asian Americans, right? It's very different being an Asian from an Asian American. Like my wife, who is Japanese, born, raised in Japan. We went and lived in Seattle, and I had this, like, thought that she was going to hang out with Japanese Americans. Like, they would have some shit to talk about. And she had nothing to talk about with Japanese Americans. Like, they just were not on her social radar at all. And I was really confused by the whole thing. And I was like, you know, I thought that would be a thing. And she was like, their experience in life has nothing to do with her experience in life, right? Her experience in life was like growing up in Japan and being Japanese and all that kind of thing. And a Japanese American's experience in life is like growing up in Japan. But I guess Valina Panda was actually born in the Philippines and then moved to the States. But like, I wonder if there's like a like an American Filipino culture that has like terms and words that they use that like a Filipino that lived in the Philippines their whole life wouldn't know about. Does that make sense?
My reference is BuzzFeed. Like, there's a bunch of Filipinos working for BuzzFeed, and they live in the US, but they know all these things about Filipino culture. I think it's because their parents still practice whatever tradition.
See, because that's the thing. I mean, you've never even been to America, have you, Monica?
No.
Have you, MJ?
Nope.
So you guys don't know, I mean, you don't know shit about Filipino Americans, really. See, like that term, like the term a Twinkie, right? I'm not going to explain that. Do the actual living in the Philippines Filipinos know the term Twinkie? Do you know what that means?
I know the food Twinkie.
Me too, the food.
See, that's the thing. That's, yeah, that any American, whether they're an American, Asian, or an American, knows the term Twinkie. And the joke is it's your yellow, as the Lena Panda says, you're yellow on the outside and white on the inside, right? And they actually have a similar term for that, the black culture, that say that they're Oreos. They're black on the outside, but white on the inside. I'm not supposed to talk about this because I'm white, right? I'm not... Race relations in America are very complex.
So what are you?
What am I? I'm a big fucking white dude from Texas. I'm nothing. I don't... And that's the thing. Like, as a white dude from Texas, I spend a lot of time really worried about what I'm allowed to talk about and what I'm not allowed to talk about. And when you leave America, it's very different. You know, like Asians in Asia talk about Asian shit all the time, and they make what in America would be considered extremely racist jokes, and they're totally cool with that, right? But in the States, you can't do that. And it's very stressful for me to be in Asia sometimes, being around Asians who are doing shit that in the States would be considered extremely racist. And I don't know, like, I'm always like, am I allowed to say this? Am I not allowed to say this? And the Asians will be like, and again, here, even when I say Asians, I mean, and like, I'm about to say actual Asians, but then, like, an Asian American would be like, dude, who are you to call an Asian an actual Asian? I'm actually Asian. And there's, like, this huge mass of you know, and it all has a history, right? They didn't just make this shit up, right? This all comes from a long and rather painful history that different races have had being racist against, or, you know, they didn't make this up for fun, right? So it's not like, I don't know, like, it's all there for a reason, but you can't, even as a white person, you really don't, like, You can't talk about this. Does that make sense?
Yes.
Yeah.
You see, you guys are just like, I don't even know what you're talking about, dude. Why are you so stressed about this? Because you're fucking Filipinos in the Philippines and have never had to deal with this shit ever, right?
Yeah, I think so.
See, somebody gets it. Fizzy Bubs, they get it. They understand my... Somebody feels my pain. I feel that somebody feels my pain. And I mean, like, I get white privilege. Like, I totally understand. I get white privilege. It's an actual, real thing, right? And whether I like it or anyone else likes it or not, I was born a white, middle-class male with college-educated parents, right? In America, right? That's like, I won some fucking lottery, right? In the world of privilege and benefits, right? I won. I mean, it's as simple as that, right? All of the media is designed for me. All of the products that are sold, they're sold to me. I'm sort of like the apex predator of the world in terms of what situation I was born into. And there's a term in comedy. They say you're never allowed to punch down. And that means, like, if you're in a position of privilege, you're never allowed to make fun of somebody who is less privileged than you. Which, if you're me, is literally everybody. So, like, I don't, like, I have to be really careful what kind of jokes I make. It's very stressful, man. I'm right here. It hits me right here. Ow, that fucking hurt. I'm kind of a pussy, apparently. Which I'm not supposed to say. See, I'm not supposed to say pussy. That's not legit. You're not allowed to use that anymore. I've actually broken out into a sweat trying to negotiate this conversation that I'm having entirely with myself about race relations in America. Ah. And I still haven't left this fucking island. In all of this conversation, I have not gotten off my stupid fucking island yet.
Yes, you did. You went to my kingdom, killed the neutron, and left. So thank you.
I know, I did. And then you came with a much bigger army, and I was like, yeah, she's totally going to kick my ass if I hang out here. So I had to leave. And now I'm like, I'm surrounded on both sides by these two allied people who are just going to kick my ass. And there's really nothing I can do about it. This is very upsetting. I'm very sad right now. But luckily, defense bonuses work. That's true. I do live on an island. I'm here on an island. It works for me. It's a big island. And you see, like, we have race shit here in Japan, too, but Japanese people don't have any understanding of race relations, like, at all. Because there's nobody here but Japanese people. And if you tell that to a Japanese person, they'll be like, oh, no, no, I saw a foreigner yesterday. And you'll be like, dude. I mean, I looked it up once. I think foreigners are less than 1% of the population here, right? And that's not just white people. I'm talking about, like, third-generation Chinese immigrants and second-generation Koreans and... like, all of us. You take every foreigner on the island, and we're less than 1% of the population. And almost all of us are in Tokyo, right? I'm in Yokohama, which is close, but it's the same thing, big city. But, like, when you try to talk to Japanese people about racism, they'll be like, oh, there's no racism in Japan. And you're like, well, you wouldn't know. You're fucking Japanese. Like, what the hell do you know about racism? And they're like, well, I've never been racist. And then, like, I go back to being a white guy in America, and I'm like, wow, I've said uneducated shit like that before. Like, you totally, like, you get to, like, as a white dude in Japan, you get to see what life being the other race is actually like. And it's very educational. It's a fascinating sort of experience. But it can be stressful as shit, actually. But on the other side, like, as a white dude in Japan, you get laid a lot. Like, when I was younger. Not now, I'm married. But, so, there's that. But then you get that same thing. Like, Japanese people will come up to you and they'll be like, you know, it really sucks that all the Japanese girls want white guys. And you're like, yeah, it's the one advantage we have here. But I'm old and married now, so it doesn't count anymore. I swear. So there's that. That went on a weird tangent, didn't it? I'll take it from the silence from the Philippines that it did. Alright, so what's going on in this game? Monica's just hanging out and building shit. And so basically you guys are just gonna box me into this little fucking island and yeah. that's your game plan?
Yeah.
That sucks, dude. That's just mean. That's just mean. Alright, fine. You want to box me into my little island? I'll stay here and I'll build troops. That's how I'll play. I'm okay with that. You want to play it like that? I'll play that. What to do? Nope, that's all I'm going to do. I got nothing else to do here. I can, actually. I can give hints, right? So... Callasia, like, the thing about Callasia is it doesn't reward people who go out and attack real fast. Like, if you try to virally zerg out, you're gonna lose. So, I built a bunch of fortresses, which was a mistake. I would have been better off to have built a bunch of, villages. So, Monica's just attacked. Which sucks. You can be damn sure that on next turn, her ally over here is also going to attack. Basically, this is a terrible time to tell you what I'm doing because I've done things so poorly. I've done such a shit job here that it's difficult for me to explain how I could have done it better. Well, that was the plan, but the problem is if you don't get more land, you don't get more money, and if you don't get more money, you end up not really being able to do very much. which is the sad fate that I have fallen under here. So one trick you can do, and this is a classic trick in the game, when you're getting your ass kicked, use the ceasefire card to run away, right? So I'm totally getting my ass whipped here, and I'm gonna get my ass even more whipped. So the best thing to do is to get the hell out of Dodge and go back to my home city to get some more troops. But Monica, being the smart little kitten that she is, decided that she would jump into my city also so that she could kick my ass there in the city. And that's actually a really smart move on her point, because if she's occupying, not occupying, but if she's sitting in or sitting on top of a building, that means I can't build anyone in that building. So that means I can't build a new hero, I can't build any new troops. So that's gonna really suck for me. So my number one goal is to get her the hell off of my city. But to be quite honest, as long as her ally plays along, they've got me pretty well killed. If MJ has half a brain, he'll jump over and take my open citadel right now while I'm busy trying to deal with Monica. Which sucks for me, man. Yeah, this is very much what not to do. I got all confused by my race relation issues, and that's really no excuse. I totally knew what I was doing, I just played shitty. I guess what you really should do is not be on an island where both ways off your island are directly towards two allied people who work for you and enjoy nothing more than destroying you publicly. That's usually a bad plan. I would steer away from that.
We were saying earlier, hey, we're neighbors, and then you didn't ally with us.
You know I'm never gonna ally with you, right, Monica? You know that's true, right?
You could have allied with MJ.
I was thinking about it, and then I was thinking, you know what? It's really cool that somebody who doesn't work for me is in the game. I'll go ally with them. That was my thinking. They're actually doing very well. They're just not really doing anything to help me much. But they're on the other side of the map, so there's not a lot they could do.
Merlini is doing better than you. Like, he's
everyone but the AI is doing better than me right now.
There's no AI. Oh, that's the tree.
Yeah, Nelson dropped, so that's AI now.
No! Merlini has occupied Nelson's castle.
Oh, so actually Nelson got kicked out, eh?
Yes.
Dude! You lost to a civilian, Nelson? You're dead to me. You're dead to me as a designer.
No, maybe he got dropped out earlier due to internet.
No, he got his ass kicked is what happened. He got his ass kicked by a civilian. The game... So MerliniX, you should know, you actually took out the game designer of the game. So that's got to be like some bragging points amongst your friends. I went and just, you know... destroyed the game designer of a game in his own game. That's pretty bold, right? I'd be proud of that. Alright, so... yeah. I should be giving more hints and tips in this game. I don't know, Monica, you're winning. Why don't you give some hints and tips? I'm not the only one here.
I don't know. Beat Chris.
Why, thank you, Monica. In all games, aim directly for the creative director. Destroy him first. But no, I mean, Monica played a really smart game, right? If you look, she built a bunch of these little cities, right? She very quickly put one hero on this, what is this land? Whatever the hell this little peninsula here is called. So she put a hero there where I couldn't come over and screw with her very hard. And then she built up all these little cities. Notice she built cities instead of fortresses. The cities actually allow you a higher population limit. The fortresses will give you a slightly higher population limit. The cities will give you a much higher population limit. But the fortresses allow you to build dudes and have defensive bonuses. And I had hoped my defensive bonus would have meant more, but it didn't, much to my chagrin. I think she played that a little smarter. But, I mean, she basically waited until she had a good opportunity. And then she hit me from two different directions. She hit me here, and she hit me there. And because I had two heroes that were smaller than her, she split my forces and did a pretty good job. It was a rather tactical ass fucking that she gave me there. So that was, you know, good on you, Monica. And I have to live another day knowing that the marketing director of the studio has again beaten me in yet another public display of my own ignorance.
I think what you shouldn't have done was to build all these towers.
Yeah, that was a mistake. I was thinking I'll build a tower on each one and I'll get the defensive bonus. But, you know, the defensive bonus really isn't that good. It's good, but it's not that great. More troops will always overcome the defensive bonus.
But look, you just might win.
Well, yeah, it's a Pyrrhic victory at best, right? So I'll win, but by the time I kill these two heroes, you're going to have this other hero that's in Buffalo Plains. That's kind of a cool name. That's going to be up here in a minute with a bunch of more troops. And I don't have a whole lot, you know, I don't have a lot of money to build a lot more troops. So you're gonna wear me down like this. Now, what is nice is MerliniX is actually putting some pressure on MJ now, because if that weren't happening, MJ would be walking in to finish me right now. So I was unkind to MerliniX before, saying that they were not helping that much. But actually, the pressure has meant something. Alright, so now things have turned around a little bit. This is looking a little bit better.
You have lots of dragons.
I do have a lot of dragons, and they are I'm all about the dragons. Let's see. So you'll notice I'm giving this away to Monica because she's watching. But I built a bunch of dudes on that castle instead of in my city. And the reason I do that
is... Yeah, I expected that.
Yeah, because they're in the castle, they're going to be garrisoned in the castle instead of moving in, which means they're going to get a much higher defensive bonus than if I put them on my armies here and brought them with me. The other thing I want to do is I want to check and see. You see right now, my two heroes aren't balanced very well. I should probably split these archers up, right, so that I have two piles of archers and two piles of dragons that are similar size. The reason for that is each one of those piles will do damage to only one more stack. So if I adjust it like that, I'm actually going to do damage to four stacks instead of just three stacks like it was before. So that's a better deal. Kill Monica. Monica also has come with many dragons. And also many guards. Alright. Let's see. So the bumper crops, you always wait till summer to play your bumper crops, because the bumper crops are going to do a x3 gold. And in the summer, you're going to get the most gold. And you can press this little button over here in the corner, and that'll tell you how much each territory gold will get. So it's always a good idea to wait till summer to play your bumper crops if you can. Ooh, I got a merchant caravan too. And the trick with a merchant caravan is you don't have to play that on your territory. You can play that on any city. So it's always good to look around and see if somebody's got a city that's making more money than your city. And you can play it on their city, and you'll still get the gold. It's kind of nice. But in this case, my city's as good as any other. I know, they asked for me to talk, and I'm giving them hints, Ben. I know, it's much game talk. But I believe a few of the people who are watching today are going to be streaming us, so I thought it would be good to give them some tips and things to share. All right, kill Monica's dragons. Oh shit! Oh shit! I got ganked. Huh. Ouch! That's brutal.
I also had ballistas.
Yeah, those ballistas. Like, a lot of the game is about the mix of troops that you bring, and if you bring the ballistas, which here I'll show you. Like, you see these ballistas. these have a huge attack, but a really shitty defense, right? So I'll get a couple of those, right? But then these guards have a really nice defense, and they're frontline. And the thing about the frontline is, that means they're going to take damage first. Which means my gimpy little ballistas aren't going to get totally destroyed right off the bat, because my guards are going to take the damage. So you saw what happened with Monica. She brought ballistas, dragons, and guards. And I had a couple dragons, but my dragons just sat and chewed on her guards. And because they just sat and chewed on the guards, they didn't ever do any damage to those ballistas. And every turn, those ballistas were just chewing me apart. And so that's why she won. Are you raising my castle?
Yes.
Damn you, woman! How dare you? Who do you think you are? Alright.
Hey, I'm solving your problem of too many towers.
Well, yeah, that you're helping me out with that too many towers problem, that's true. I thought for sure you were gonna attack, but I guess not. Oh shit. No, don't do that.
Ah.
All right.
My battery is low.
You don't have a plug?
No, I found it already.
All right. So I bought my kids laptops when I was in the States. I bought them like these kind of shitty laptops, like the one Nelson bought. And, sorry, Nelson. I tested them both before I came back to Japan, because I know it would be a problem if one of them was broken. And they were fine. They worked. They were great. I was happy with them. I brought them back to Japan. The minute I got them back to Japan, my son's laptop stopped working. The fucking hard drive crashed. And it's like one of these SSD hard drives, so it's the only hard drive in the machine. There's nothing I can do. I gotta send it back. And I was like, all right, where do I send it back? And they were like, oh, you have to send it to us in America, because Lenovo apparently won't let me do it in Japan. And I've done the math. By the time I'm done shipping the thing to America and back and everything, I will spend more money in shipping than I spent on the machine. That's a real number. That's actually gonna be like that. You know what? I'm gonna take it. I'm gonna go. I'm gonna do it. Not enough gold. Fuck you, I need more gold. Alright. Ah! I can see you've been playing a lot of this game, Monica. You've gotten better.
Playing it every day when you were gone.
See, you've got the advantage. I spent all my time watching noobs play, so, you know. But they were nice noobs. I liked them. They were all nice people, but they didn't teach me anything in the way that playing myself would have. Alright, I think this may be it for me. I'm not sure how I come back from this. Because that's going to be my last hero killed. And that's going to be you taking over my city. Ah! The pain. The shame.
Bye, Erica.
Oh. Oh. Ouch. Ouch. Nope, there's nothing I can do. It's just a matter of turns before I'm out now. All I can do is break some of Monica's shit just to make her feel bad. I have to play some peasant revolts on her to spite her. Although, actually, it's looking pretty good for MerliniX. So, we haven't actually had this happen before, where there was still... I mean, because there's still a lot of game to be played in this game, but I'm not going to be in it. What do we do with it? What do we do with the live stream when the live streamer is entirely out of the game? What becomes of the live stream then?
That's why I'm not occupying your castle.
Oh, you're gonna let me live just for the purposes of keeping the live stream alive?
Yes.
You are the marketing director, aren't you?
But we'll never know if you have a card that kicks me out of your castle.
We should have a card you could play that allows you to move somebody else's hero. Like, exactly where you want them to go.
There's battle there, but only...
Yeah, but that sends them, like, somewhere weird. Like have it be, like, a mind control card. Because we have the tech to tell your allies where you want them to go, right? So you could play the card and then, like, drag them where you want them to go. That'd be cool. It's got a lot of corner cases and shit that would be weird, though. Adrian would not like me for doing it. Wow, I've eaten a lot of grapes during this. I've eaten about a pound of grapes during this live stream. I'm not proud. Alright, god damn it. What to do? I play some cards, I guess. Well, that's just mean, Monica. You're not gonna take my castle, you're just gonna sit on it and defend. You suck, woman.
Hey, that's a saying, there's no stream and no audio.
What? There's no audio? My little mic says that there's audio.
Maybe it's Nelson's internet.
Here, wait. I'm not gonna take my castle. You're just gonna sit on it.
No,
and I just checked. It's all working.
All right.
I checked my own stream here. I think it's... Well, this game is not... This game's a long way from over, MerliniX. It's just over for me. Although... I think MerliniX has still got a shot in this, but... I don't know, it depends on how mean Monica wants to be, because... See, now, if Monica were to break her alliance with Red... But it's true, as two alliances, I think it's over. Alright! If we assume that Red and Blue remain allied, I think MerliniX is out. So, she... Is MerliniX a man or a woman?
Man.
Okay, so he is suggesting that we start another game. Who's up for another game?
Really? Merlini's giving up?
Well, I mean, as long as you guys stay allied, he's out. I mean, there's no way he's going to beat both of you.
But you're still alive.
Well, only marginally.
But no, Merlini has two castles.
Yeah, but he's got four heroes versus your four heroes... I think if he could win, it would be an epic victory on his part. But I mean, MJ alone has two castles, plus you have one castle, plus the one that you would take if you weren't just being mean to me. So I say we start a second game. That's my vote. But of course, I would vote that because I'm losing. Of course, that would be my vote. The answer of when do we usually stream and play together? We do a stream every day at 11 o'clock Tokyo, 10 o'clock Manila. What is that American times? Does anyone know?
What again?
What time is it in America now?
West
Coast,
start
it's
at
8 p.m., so we
EST,
start at... Yeah, so we start
7
at 7... Yeah, 7 p.m. West, is that right? 7 p.m. West Coast?
Yep.
Yeah. Usually, at this time, I'll play through the campaigns. Wait, is it... What time is it Eastern now? Yeah, so it's... I'm so confused.
8 p.m., I think.
Yeah, so right now, it's 8 o'clock in L.A., which makes it 9, 10, 11 o'clock in New York. And we started an hour ago, so yes, 10 o'clock Eastern is when we start.
That's what I said.
Again, have we not covered the whole I don't believe that you know anything, Monica? Have we not been through that already? Alright, you gotta put me out of my misery at least, Monica, because I keep forgetting to press the end turn button and I'm making this game take forever. Take my castle, and I will spectate. Do it, Monica. Put me out of my misery. Make it happen. Alright.
Triple Dude is going to win by VP.
Alright. I'm officially dropping this game. I'm surrendering. Oh, alright. Oh wait, so theoretically I can go in and spectate it though. Join Sorinthia Spectator. Let's see if spectate mode works. I've never done it. They tell me it works. Now wait, that's weird because it tells me that you guys have formed an alliance when I start, and it actually puts a stream of every single thing that ever happened in the game on my screen. That's kind of cool. Alright. Alright.
Hi. I'm Aramia.
It's an exact 12-hour difference between East Coast and Manila. I did not know. Yeah, I do this every weekday. So yeah, I'm here every weekday doing this. And we're talking about, I'm not sure when, I'm thinking next week, we are going to do Chris plays every single campaign mission from start to finish. And I think we've scheduled that out. It's going to be something like 35 hours solid. I think that's... How long was it taking you to play the campaigns, Monica? Because you were doing some in like half an hour, right?
Depending on the campaign. Like, I finished some at 20 minutes. I finished some at 2 hours.
Were they more like 2 hours or more like 20 minutes?
More 2 hours.
Ah! The game has ended! Okay, wait, so can we all agree that that looked shit? Like, that pop-up looks bad? Can we fix that? That's on the list of stuff that needs to get fixed.
But it still doesn't say that we're allies in the results screen.
Oh, wow. And apparently, if a game ends while you're spectating, it crashes the game. That's cool. Are you crash you too?
Yeah.
It
didn't
crash on mine.
It definitely crashed on mine.
Did someone click on the X button for the victory message?
Not that I remember. I might have.
I don't remember.
Wow, that's the first hard crash I've seen in our game in a really long time. Ooh, wait, and it won't load up again either. Look at this. Live, online, I can't get the game to run. Okay, now it works. It just wanted to crash one more time.
And I are both in the multiplayer lobby.
Alright, are we playing another game?
Who's hosting?
You've got most of the stuff open. You're hosting.
What map?
Let's play another big one so that more people can play. What else have we got for six player?
A six player map?
Yeah.
I think Edwin wants to join.
Well then, Edwin, get on the thing.
Wait, let me poke.
Tolroth or Glacier Lands? Tolroth?
I don't know if a speed run is what it will actually be. What we're actually doing is I'm going through and making sure nothing's broken before we release the game. We're still in early access, so the game's not done yet. It still does stuff like, as you can see, crash every now and then. Oh, that's really rare. I haven't seen a real live crash in a long time. But yeah, so the idea is I want to go through every single level and say, like, I played them all. It's good. It has my seal of approval. Ooh, I got invited to Tolroth. Yay!
Redwin's joining.
Yay! Okay, so you know the rule is we don't let Edwin win. I will even let Monica win before I will... I like how I say let Monica win. They're just like publicly losing. I'm like, yeah, I'll let Monica win. That's pretty low class of me, actually. That's low class.
Icon is like...
Say what?
It's like the Pope.
Pope
person
thing.
Gets a message.
It works. It's cool. No.
Okay, we're waiting for you.
And
because I've seen a lot of the streamers wonder, what's that thing?
Which thing?
The finger, in the multiplayer screen.
The finger.
Or does the host only see it? Who's setting the options?
Me.
Nightmare AI.
I didn't do that.
More
that was somebody else.
Okay.
That was not me. Where do I want to start? All right.
Yeah, it was MJ who's setting it.
I'm checking if there are missing.
Locks. Yeah, the gold option.
A little quiet testing taking place.
Is the option starting gold more?
Yeah, I think Nelson's adding that.
I did that.
Wait, are we waiting for one more player?
Does anyone else want in? We have people in the lobby. Anyone in?
There's no one else.
No, I say we start.
Is Ben or Nelson joining?
No.
Well, I think Nelson dropped. I don't know where Nelson went.
I think he's adjusting some of the home pins.
Alright. Well, I don't want to interrupt him working. Let's go. Alright, nobody ally with Edwin.
Sure.
That's the rule. Nobody allies with Edwin.
I don't think Edwin wants to ally with me anymore.
He's had experiences, huh?
So, who are my neighbors? Oh no, Edwin is beside me.
Well, we can ally and trap him on that spot.
Wait, where is Edwin?
The purple one.
Oh, he's over on the edge there. Who got the shit spot? Who's orange and red?
I'm orange.
MerliniX is red. Those are the shit spots on this map.
Well, it depends. Yeah.
It all depends on alliances.
We didn't change the AI, right? It's still Nightmare.
No, I set it to one level below Nightmare, whatever that is.
I haven't tried Nightmare AI yet.
It just
I'm not
it,
sure.
They don't, I mean, it doesn't really do anything to the they're not any smarter, they're just a lot angrier. They just kind of go right for your throat. But we don't ever cheat the AI. The AI never cheats, like we never like let them roll better. That never happens.
But I think we decided that at some point.
Ah, and the first alliance takes place.
And it's just the first turn.
Turn one. The alliances have already begun. All right, the sides have been drawn.
Edwin doesn't have any allies.
Yeah, screw you, Edwin. No allies for you.
So, Chris, who do you hate more, me or Edwin?
Edwin.
Haha. Yes.
I don't hate you. I just can't. I can't deal with being beat by a girl. I think is really. That's not true. I swear to God, that sexist shit I just said was not true. That's not at all. No, it's. I just can't deal with watching Edwin win again. I've seen Edwin win so many games of this that it just. It offends me at some deep level to watch Edwin win a game. It hurts me deep down. Alright, let's see. Alright, so it wouldn't be a Boom Zap live stream without somebody's dog. There's a rule. We seem to have the rule's been followed. Whose dog was that?
MJ's.
MJ's got a dog?
Like every day during your stream you mention his dog and you forget.
Do you really think I can remember every animal that every Filipino on this staff has? You guys have like a zoo. Like you're not really from the Philippines unless you got like four animals living in your house. There's a law, I think.
I don't have animals living in my house.
Yeah, that's because you run a business out of your house. That's different. Oh wait, do you anymore? You moved, didn't you?
His house.
I thought your parents ran a business out of your house.
We moved that too.
So that's not in the house anymore?
Still in the house.
Well, see, then it follows... No, so my point is, that follows the pattern. As a Filipino, you either have to have a bunch of animals in your house or a home business. Those are your options. The home business or the animals. Admit it, I'm right. I like the new noises that Shaz put in for when I click things. I spend a lot of time clicking things now.
The whale has a creepy sound.
I never see the whale. Come on. The harpies are cool though.
I like the exploding sounds when clicking.
So there's this one bird. You're not going to see it because it's done on the client, but there's one bird that's just going in a circle, like a non-stopping loop. I wonder if I could click it. Will it stop? I don't know. No. There's an endless looping harpy in my screen. That's kind of weird.
Go home, harpy, you're drunk.
Go home, harpy, you're drunk. All right. I don't know what the fuck I see this harpy. It's like going in a little circle, just over and over and over again. I've never seen him do that before. Can we write that down as a bug, MJ? Because that's weird. I'm not comfortable with it. I'm uncomfortable with it. I'm very uncomfortable about it. All right. I'm making a bold move this turn. We'll see if it's a good one or not. All right, kill, kill, kill. I think I may have overextended. I think I may have made a mistake, but we'll see. Nope, nope, I think it's gonna come out alright. Alright, you build me a new dude. No? Is that enough? Can I get, do I have any cheap dudes? No, no cheap dudes. Ah. Alright. Fight it out. I'm determined to click on this harpy again. Damn it. Come here, harpy. No, no. See, we had an idea, which I think was a cool idea, that you got one gold every time you killed an animal by clicking on it, but the problem is that's on the client and it's too cheatable. Alright. Die, 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 die. Alright, alright. I'm gonna win that eventually. That's gonna turn out well for me. Down. Find me a new hero. Missile attacker, melee attacker, bring me a melee attacker. Down. Loot the ruins. Alright, now I got all into my thinking and I stopped talking and I forgot I was on a live stream. I'm supposed to, like, do stuff. That's the thing, like, I'm not really an entertainer, I'm a game developer, so, like, I don't really know how to, like... You know, you see other people do live streams and you think, like, wow, that's really easy, that dude's just, like, playing a game and talking. And I know how to talk, and I know how to play games, so that seems like something I could do. And you think, like, easy to pull off. And then you realize that, like... Saying things, even for like an hour, gets pretty like... You kind of run out of shit to say. I'm not that interesting. I mean, I'm not interesting by any stretch, but I'm certainly not interesting enough to keep people's attention for like 2 hours. I mean, I could get drunk. Actually, okay, so we actually had a big... You weren't here for the debate. I was in Seattle last week. Seattle has legal weed. And I had not... I actually got my MBA at UW in Seattle back before there was legal weed. And I left when it was still illegal to get stoned. I mean, it was Seattle, so it was always, you know, just kind of illegal. It wasn't really, really illegal. But now it's, like, totally legit. You can, like, go to the weed store and buy weed in Seattle, which is amazing, right? I've never seen that before. So I thought I should get stoned on Twitch because, you know, they have a big thing that says... You can't do things that are illegal. But in Seattle, being, you know, getting stoned is actually completely legal. That's totally legit. And so we had a big debate about whether or not it would violate the Twitch, you know, service, whatever, for me, like, am I allowed to get stoned on Twitch or not if I'm in Seattle where it's legal? We had a very big debate about this. Where did we come down on it, Monica? I think we decided no, right? That's why I didn't do it?
Mm-hmm.
Why did we decide no?
Because we have to respect international laws.
But still, I'm...
But if you want to do it, I can't do anything.
But that's the thing, like, there's all kinds of... I mean, there is no such thing as international law, right? There's only national laws. And you have to abide the law of the place that you're in. And so, like, in some places, it's illegal for women to drive cars. So can I not show that on Twitch? Like, in some places, it's illegal for me to eat pork. Can I not show that on Twitch? I'm not picking on Muslims. Those are just the two things that came to mind. What?
It depends on where your viewers are. If you're encouraging them to do something illegal.
But I'm not. I'm encouraging them to go to Seattle and enjoy legal Seattle weed. That's what I was like a little, it would have been like a little Seattle, you know. I don't know why they don't have that in their fucking travel brochures at this point. Like, if I were on the Washington State tourism whatever, that would be all I would ever write. Would just be like, come to Seattle and get stoned as fuck. That would be, you know, that would be on all the brochures. Seattle, where you can get stoned and not get arrested. Like, why is that not on every brochure now? And it was real weird. Like, when I walked into the weed store, like, you know, because I'm so, and I shouldn't say this because I mean, this has got to be illegal. But in any case, I can remember back when buying weed meant like you had to go, like, sit in a car and wait for some dude you didn't know named Doug, and you had to pretend to like Doug's shitty ass fish bootleg tapes, and, you know, listen to him talk about his fucking Canadian girlfriend for a while before he would finally pull out some really terrible weed, and you would buy this, like, really seed-crusted, smelled like gasoline somebody carried across from Mexico in a truck weed, right? And now you just, like, walk in, and they're like, show me your license, and you show them a license, and they're like, what would you like? And I was so, like, I was so just almost numb from shock at, like, you know, I have choice, and they were like, well, we have oils, and we have brownies, and we have cookies, and we have, you know, we have pre-rolled joints for you, and I was just, it was some serious future shit, and I was really confused by the whole thing. It was, you know, and then I spent 2 days very, very stoned. So now I've begun to wonder maybe I shouldn't live in Seattle because I'm not sure I'd get very much done there. I was not particularly productive on my Seattle trip. He started talking like Doug. Tree, bird. No, okay, so I was at PAX South, and when I went to PAX South, I had this booth all by myself, and I was like, shit, I can't run this booth by myself. I need somebody to help me out. And it so happened that my parents' neighbors, who are good friends of theirs, have this cousin who is a live streamer. And I was like, hey, I've got a free ticket to PAX if you want to come down and, you know, help me work the booth. So this guy, a really, really nice guy, he came down by the way, he's on Twitch. Shout out Jack Wolf Gaming. But anyway, he came out, and he's a young kid. He's 20 something, which to me is a kid. I'm 43. I'm old as shit. And so he was sitting next to me, and he just would not stop talking. Like, the whole time I was there, he was just like nonstop talking at me, and I wondered, like, you know, what the hell? Like, what's up with this dude? And then I realized that it's the Twitch, right? That's like, he had trained himself to fill every single second of silence with noise because that's what you have to do here. And he was like, just like, that was now the way he behaved. And it was fascinating to realize that you could really change yourself like that based on, you know, what you do. I was fascinated by the whole thing. But I'm also easily fascinated, so, you know, there's that. No, you're gonna build some shit. That's what you're gonna...
Oops.
Yeah, alright, that works. Yeah, I don't have, like, a cool, like, Twitch name. I used my old, like, I have an internet name. Like, if you're as old as me, you have an internet name from back when we all had handles on the internet because they're, you know, we were on IRC and shit. And my name is unpronounceable in Japanese. They can't say Chris. They call me Kurisu. And ku in Japanese means nine, and disu means squirrels. So I became nine squirrels. So that's my shitty little internet handle. So I guess I use that on Twitch, but like, I don't know. I don't like love it. I don't feel it. You know, I don't feel like I'm. It's not a persona that I think about very much. It just happens to be the name I use on the internet sometimes. So I used it for Twitch. I'm not sure why. So I got talking about shit and kind of lost track of what I'm trying to do here. What am I doing with you? Can you do something? Go back there. Build some stuff there. I'm gold short again. Yeah, it is true though. When I speak a different language, I do turn into kind of a different dude. Like I've got like my English language speaking persona and my Japanese language speaking persona. And people who know me from Japan, they're always really surprised when they see me in English, because in English I say fuck a lot and I'm quite blunt and rude. But because I learned Japanese from my family, I didn't, you know, I don't even know how to curse in Japanese. I don't know any Japanese curse words. I don't really know how to be rude in Japanese. And so in Japanese, I come across totally different. I come across like really polite, which I know people who know me are like, that's not physically possible that Chris comes across as polite. But it is true. It does actually work out like that. It is hard to believe, isn't it? Me, polite. Like, come on, admit it. You have a hard time swallowing that, right? Let's see, 30, let's see, get my bumper crop on the big one. I'm actually going to throw away that Summon Death Knights card because it's worth a lot of money. And sometimes it's worth it to ditch the money and use it to build stuff. Sometimes that's a better plan. It is true, I'm way more polite when I'm speaking in Japanese. And how the hell would you know, Ben? You don't speak Japanese. I could say anything to you, and you would think it was polite in Japanese.
Baka.
What? Did you just say baka?
She said cow.
We should start Philippine Language Day again. I should start learning my Filipino again. That was fun when we were doing that. We should get back to that later. Not today though. I'm not in a Filipino language learning mood today.
Teach us Japanese.
What do you want to learn? I'll teach you anything in Japanese. I can say anything in that language. You want to say alpaca in Japanese?
Alpaca.
It is in fact alpaca. That one's pretty easy.
Arupaka.
Yeah, there's a bunch of shit in Japanese which is just like, yeah, pronounce this funny. And it's Japanese. Like, sweater is like seta. It's, and you always feel like an asshole saying it, you know? You feel like...
Kapikiku.
I can't make myself do that. Every time I do that, I feel like that guy who likes anime and he starts... And the worst is, like, when you actually do speak Japanese, people who know that you speak Japanese, who are Japanese, they expect you to say shit in Japanese correctly, right? And so, like, I can't say computer anymore. I have to say computer. Which is annoying because now you sound like a dick. Right? Or like when I'm speaking in English and I want to say a Japanese word in the middle of an English sentence, like I want to say my son takes karate, right? Japanese people get all edgy when I say karate because they're like, it's karate. But like, I don't want to be that dude that's like, my son takes karate. Like, that sounds like you sound like a dick, right? You sound like the guy who knows two words of Japanese and wants to show it off. And I don't want to be that guy, but I'm usually in front of like my son or my wife, and you know, they speak Japanese better than I do, and they're like, why are you talking like a fucking redneck? Why don't you say the word properly? It's like really annoying.
But karate isn't
is Japanese, right? Or not?
Yeah, of course it's Japanese.
So you're still saying it wrong. It's not an English word.
Yeah, but like, Americans don't say karate. Americans say karate, right?
Karate.
Yeah, we have, you know, in the same way that Japanese people don't say computer, they say computa, right?
Hambaga.
Hambaga, yeah, and that kind of annoying Hakunado. Japanese shit, right? Cupcakey. You saw that. God, that fucking video. Did you see that fucking video?
Yes, I watched that over and over.
Holy shit, I wanted to find that guy, that American guy, and just...
Karate.
beat the living shit out of him. Like, I'm sure he's not a bad kid. I'm sure he's just a dude, right? But there was just something about that video that I wanted nothing more than to just put him on the floor and just beat him silly. That was annoying.
I enjoyed it.
Come live in Asia as an American.
I think he lives in Asia. Like, he speaks... I don't know what language.
I got the feeling that his language that he was good at was Korean. But I think he's one of those people who knows like 20 words in a bunch of languages. Have you ever met those people? I hate those people. Like they're like, oh yeah, I speak German. And then you find out that like they know how to say like 5 things in German, but they're really fucking proud of it, you know? Whereas like Japanese people are the actual opposite. When you meet like real live, honest to God Japanese people, they'll be like, you know, do you play guitar? And they're like, oh no, I play a little. And then you find out they took like 20 years of lessons and they played better than Billy Gibbs. And you're like, well, why didn't you say? And they're like, well, because, you know, I'm not perfect yet. Like, but Americans are the exact opposite, right? An American takes like 3 weeks of Spanish classes and suddenly wants to fucking call himself Jose. It's like, it's really annoying. And you're just like, you people have no goddamn humility at all. Ah. But you see, now I'm that guy. Now I'm that guy who's the guy who's talking shit about America, who doesn't live in America anymore. And you know who Americans hate? They hate that guy, right? That I don't live in your country anymore and I talk shit about your club. Like, ah. You're right. I'm overthinking it. But that's what I do. That's who I am. I'm that guy who overthinks shit.
That's it's weird when I was live streaming and talking to Nelson in straight English.
So that like had to normally... be weird. Like you and Nelson talking to each other and like pointedly not saying anything in Filipino.
Yep. And then at the end of one of the streams, we didn't understand what each other was saying.
That's awesome!
Like, when you talk in Tagalog, you already know what to say, but when you speak it in English, like, you have to make shortcuts of what you're trying to say.
You know, but like, what's always fascinating to me about Filipinos is Filipinos never just, like, hang out and speak Filipino, right? Ah, the AI is dead. MerliniX has killed the AI.
Monica, go attack Edwin. He's attacking me.
I will attack him?
Yeah. I think he's going straight for me. Cause
yeah, I'm trying to occupy the lands he occupied. Okay, I'll send one of my heroes. Maybe?
You're like the shittiest ally ever.
We're not allies.
Wait, who are you? Who's ally? Wait, I'm allied to you.
Yeah, but you're on the far side, so you can't help.
Yeah, I'm useless. I'm over here. I gotta fuck up MerliniX. That's my thing.
But we don't want Edwin to win, so Monica can attack while Edwin attacks me.
Wait, why is Monica always blue?
I don't know.
Do you choose blue, or does it just work out that way?
I choose it.
Okay, is that like your favorite color?
Yeah.
Why did you say that like I'm dumb? Like, goddamn, Chris, how did you not know my favorite color? How the fuck am I supposed to know your favorite color, Monica?
I don't know.
But that voice, it was like my daughter when I say something stupid. She's got that like teenage you're so stupid dad voice. She's like, she's 12 now, which is just like right at the edge of being a teenager. And she's just at the age where she's decided her dad is dumb. Like, up till now, and it's a real, it's a, like a real change. You don't know that this isn't gonna happen, but it happens. Cause up till now, I was smart to her. She thought I knew stuff, you know? And I can remember, she even, I can remember her even saying like, you know, Dad, why are you so smart? Why do you know all this stuff? And lately, that shit's come to an end. Lately, it's like, Dad, why are you so stupid? How do you not know this? It's really a, it's a sad moment when you become stupid to your daughter. It hurts me a little inside.
See, Ben says we all know Monica loves blue.
That's just Ben being Ben. I don't believe anything Ben says. You know how you know when Ben's lying? His lips move.
Happened to my troops?
Hmm.
Was a card played on me? I don't
possible.
Remember.
Wow, Monica's taken like that whole damn island. Quietly kicking ass while nobody notices. Let's see here.
Chris, you're not helping your ally.
I'm working my way over there right now.
Why am I the one helping your ally?
Because we don't want Edwin to win. It's a very simple logic here. You're working against the Edwin win. That's all we have to achieve today. And you know what's going to happen? We're all going to work on making sure that Edwin doesn't win really hard. And because of that, MerliniX is going to win. That's how this is going to end.
But we're allies.
Wait, that sucks for me. So really what's going to happen is I'm going to lose again. That's how this is going to go down, really?
Are you losing, MJ, or not?
No.
No? Is Edwin losing?
Yes.
Okay.
Alright, that's all we needed to know. My bloodlust is satisfied. Yeah, all right, that's how I play it. Wait, what? No? Oh, yeah, you. What are you doing?
Hey, what's taking you so long?
I was thinking.
Yes. Who played the to the death? On
me!
Okay, that's nice. I couldn't play a to the death because I don't have a warrior hero.
That's why I asked you if who's losing. Edwin's gonna remember
money? I feel very
again.
I've had a couple games where I just can't seem to like make money. I feel I'm managing my money poorly. Um,
Edwin dropped out of the game?
What? He's a poor loser. I'm unimpressed, Edwin. Unimpressed, I tell you.
Hey, Chris.
What? Huh?
End turn.
I was still doing stuff. I was thinking. Uh-oh, I'm getting attacked. Badly. Bad things happening. Ooh, he's got a pretty good little army there, doesn't he?
He wants revenge on you.
I didn't do anything to him. I just
you
was
were
a shitty
ally.
Ally.
Yeah.
But I'm always a shitty ally. That's what I do. That's kind of my role in this whole thing. To be the shitty ally. So the way the timer works is pretty straightforward. The timer won't start until somebody says end turn. So if we're all thinking, then the timer won't start. When the first person says end turn, the timer starts, and then you've got a certain amount of time. And then whoever finishes, you get a time bonus, a gold bonus for finishing earlier to kind of encourage you to go faster. Once the timer is out, then the turn is over whether you're done or not. And you have to just kind of suck it up and deal with it. Yeah, that's how that works. It's reasonably straightforward. You know, the thing is, you don't feel the timer very much unless you're, like, doing a whole lot of thinking. And the other thing is, if you're not playing multiplayer, there's no timer at all. The timer only happens in multiplayer. During the campaign sessions, there's no timer at all. The AI will never start a timer against you. The AI don't give a shit about time. So it's only when there's other human players in the game that we ever care about time. Hey! MerliniX is in my castle! Get out of my castle! It's actually pretty low stress to stream. Every now and then you kind of have to like shut up for a second and think about what you're doing, but you don't have to think that hard. Damn it. I thought I had a portal here. Damn it. I thought I was going to be smart and portal down and save my city.
Were you going to portal there?
I was totally going to portal down to my city, but I don't have a portal, so that's not going to happen. That sucks. I was robbed. I feel very unhappy right now. But these things happen. I'm gonna work my way through this pain. It's gonna be alright. Alright. We still have a lot of turns left. Is anyone near the... Ooh, MerliniX just went way up in the score.
Ooh. No, he was on the top even before.
Yeah, but he just went way up because he just took my castle.
Yeah. And you went down.
Don't sound so like you had anything to do with it. Don't be all like, yeah. You had fuck all to do with that. That's totally him and not you at all. You just lucked into the right ally. You don't get bragging rights for that.
I'm second. We have the same.
Well, that you can be both. That you can brag about. You can brag about your own victories. That's legit. Aw, oh, dude, I forgot to play my bumper crop card. Arrgh. Actually, MerliniX is in a pretty good position. I put more money on him than Monica. Of course, with Edwin dropping out like a little... See, in another world, in a less PC world, I would say like a little bitch, right? That's what I would have said. But I get it. I'm not supposed to say that. So, what do I say instead of like a little bitch now? What is my replacement for you're being a little bitch? What is my new terminology that I can use that is non whatever, not bad? When I want to say someone's being a little bitch, but I don't want to say bitch. What do I say? Monica, come on, you're a woman. Help me out here.
Walang kwenta.
Not in Filipino. That doesn't help.
What? I don't know. You suck.
But I'm not like. But I want that feeling of like. You know, when you're. Again, I don't mean it to sound bad to women, but that thing when somebody is being a little bitch, they're just like a whiny little, you know. You're like, oh, don't be like that. Don't be that person. Like, how do I say
drama
that?
Queen.
What?
I don't know. Drama queen.
Not drama queen. That's not quite it.
No, Ben, I'm not going to break the alliance.
I know I just said it, but I'm trying to. I'm trying to better myself. I'm looking for a better word.
Call her a potato. Wait.
Well, I wasn't actually calling Monica that. I was calling Edwin that. It's not a her, but I could... Is that it? Is it... All right.
A potato.
Wait. The new PG meme? What's PG as in, like, PG rated? Or... Is PG a thing? Is this a kid's thing that I don't know? Is this more millennial shit that I don't know? I'm surrounded by millennials. I don't speak their language. It's totally true. I'm totally surrounded by millennials all day. I have no idea what they're talking about. It's a complete mystery to me what they're saying or doing. I'm totally lost amongst the millennials. And I used to always think, like, my parents are so out of it, they're so not cool, and now I totally get it. You can't keep up. And even if you could keep up, you're that, like, lame old 40-year-old dude trying to sound like he can talk like millennials talk, and then you're that dude, and you don't want to be that dude, right? So, like, it's like a catch 42. You can't win, right? Catch 42? Catch 22. Like, there's no winning it. There's no, like... You know, you're damned if you do it. You know, if you try to sound like a millennial, then you're the loser who's trying to sound like a millennial. If you don't, you sound like an old man. Like, you can't win. There's no winning. Am I gonna win that fight? Maybe. You know what? Okay, so here's a trick for you. He's going to bring those 23 over to that fight and win that fight. I'm going to take my little bullshit one hero, and because whoever's got the lower number goes first, I'm going to throw that hero on top of that 23 army that's going to attack me, and that's going to pin them because they can't move because they got attacked because I get to go first. And that's going to keep that 23 army from going over into that fight. That's a cheap trick that you can play in our game. I give that to you. Potato. I'm going to take that. I'm going to take potato. I'm going to call people a potato.
This is how you repay me, MJ.
Get her, MJ. Get her.
Yeah.
No mercy. Kill, kill. Kill, kill. He's got so many phoenixes, though. Ouch. Ouch. Boom. Yeah. MerliniX has learned the overpowered phoenix plus treant trick. Which is a good trick. I gotta tone down those phoenixes a little bit. Yeah, things are looking bad for me. I don't know. Monica and MerliniX are pretty high in the charts there, MJ. I think we may have lost this one.
Yeah. Ripping it, so.
Why you choose that?
I was trying it out.
Testing.
Yes. It's what I do.
I lost because I was testing.
Yeah, I need to figure out a better way to let people know how movement works, because there is an order to it. There is a whoever's got the lowest number goes first order, but we never really teach that to the player. And I think knowing that does power a lot of tactical decisions about how you move things. So we need to figure out a way to make that a little bit more obvious to the player.
We need a better tutorial.
Yeah, we still get people who whine about the tutorial. We get a lot of negative, but I mean, that tutorial is pretty old. It's kind of survived a lot of game changes, so I don't think it's really fully explaining the game in the way that it used to. Nobody reads a manual, Ben. You know that. Nobody reads a manual. Why have I got Nelson in the slideshow and not... I'm going to fix that while I wait for this turn to be over. I'm going to go over and... Because Nelson's... You know... I don't want to talk bad about Nelson, but MJ's a much better looking guy, really. And I don't mean that in like a weird gay way. Not that that's wrong, but let's face it, MJ's just a better looking piece of man than Nelson is. So we're going to put him up. Do we have a picture of Nelson with his new fancy short haircut?
Nelson had the haircut?
Yeah, he got all his hairs cut off. See, look, there's MJ. Isn't MJ just a better looking guy than Nelson?
I have a picture of him.
Wait.
Monica always has a picture of everyone.
I know, well, she's our PR person. That's her job.
That's my job.
It's what she does, MJ. You test, she has pictures of people. That's how the studio works.
It's kind of scary.
Dude, like you want to know what's scary? About half of the interviews that I give is actually Monica writing for me. I would say, a good solid half of every time I do an interview, you're actually hearing Monica pretending to be me.
Which reminds me, you haven't answered one of the interviews. I couldn't answer that things about your childhood.
Not yet. Soon. Soon you'll be able to handle the childhood questions. It's just a matter of time before you can answer the childhood questions. Okay, maybe you're right. Maybe I do want to talk bad about everyone. Hey, we could make videos. I've never really thought of doing like a tutorial video where people talk through the video. That'd be kind of cool. We have those online. Yes, you walked right into my trap, MerliniX. Wasn't a very good trap, though. You're gonna kick my ass with all the phoenixes. It was the best trap I could come up with. Oh, wow! I got brutalized!
I signed you a pic, Chris.
What? You signed me up for what?
I sent you a pic.
Wait, alright. No! Really? Wait, who's the guy on the right?
He's an actor. Filipino actor. He was famous in the 90s. Like, he was a teen star in the 90s.
You see, because when he had the long hair, he looked just like Dave Grohl from Nirvana, is what he looked like with the long hair. But now he doesn't look like that anymore. So what happened? What? Why the short hair? What was the...
Maybe because it's hot?
Well, yeah, okay. I wouldn't want to have long hair in the Philippines. I can understand that. I think it's going to be a couple more turns and MerliniX is going to get a full victory because he's going to take my castle. When he takes my castle, that's probably going to be worth enough points to put him over the edge.
Yeah, we lost this one.
We've lost this one. Wow, that's two losses, and we probably had the biggest audience we've had yet today. And I had to lose in front of them twice and say a bunch of racist shit. But, you know, the racist shit's pretty much par for the course. We do that every day. The Booms Up corporate Twitch, where we say racist shit and...
No, where Chris says racist shit.
Well, that's true. Where Chris says racist shit. But at least I can't get fired, really, so that's a bonus. Yeah, I'm out. I got nothing. That's me. Gone.
You're out?
Yeah, he's got four heroes on my castle. I think that's enough to take it in one turn. Cause I don't think I ever upgraded it to make it harder to take. Boom. That's me out. Ow! Real live, honest to God. Hey, MJ, can you take a note? If I get killed in a multiplayer game where it says quit right here, there should be a button right underneath it that says spectate so that I can immediately go spectate.
Alright.
Because right now I gotta go out, I gotta go back to multiplayer, I got to go find the multiplayer game, and I have to... Oh, and I can't... It won't let me spectate. I can join, though. That's weird. No, it won't let me do it. Now it'll let me spectate.
Heh.
Alright. I believe this is MerliniX's game. Unless something magical happens very fast. Nope, that's it. And in fact, I think he's got the rest of Black Thistle taken over in another couple turns. So that'll go pretty quick.
What's MJ doing?
Dying.
No, he hasn't ended his turn yet.
Oh, sorry. I was typing the notes, but I'm pretty sure I'm dead.
Yeah, I don't see much hope for you either, dude. The only question at this point is which one of the allies gets the higher score total to win. Is it going to be Monica? Because Monica's going to get a big boost when she takes over your city here in a second. Is that going to put her... Oh! The alliance is broken! Oh! Who did that? Was that you, Monica? Your silence is a yes. You know it is. Ah, but Merlin is over the score total. No, I think this is Merlin's game. He's going to get it all by his lonesomes, and there's nothing Monica can do about it. I don't think there's any... I don't see any path. I don't know. Actually, if she takes over that city, how much is that worth? See, we should have a thing that tells you how many victory points that's worth. Oh, wait, we do. It's right here. So that's worth... What is that worth? 100 and something points? Maybe if she built a couple dolmens real quick. So somehow Monica's got to pick up an extra 100 victory points real fast. It's possible. Dude, Monica wins! Surprise come from behind victory. Monica wins.
I was surprised myself.
All right, and on that note, I believe we are done with today's live stream. And again, because I was spectating when the game is over, it crashed. Can we make sure that Adrian fixes that?
Mine's crashed again.
Yeah, it's got something to do with somebody being in spectator mode when the game is over. I think that's what it is.
It's the same bug with the looping victory sound I reported last time.
All right, so this was huge fun. MerliniX, thanks so much for coming along and playing multiplayer with us. I think we'll probably do this again tomorrow. This was fun. Let's play another map multiplayer tomorrow. We'll see if we get some other civilians to join us as well. That's it for today.
Sorry for breaking the alliance.
You suck, Monica. And we will see you on the next live stream tomorrow. Bye-bye.